Hey guys, just finished cleaning off my workbench and getting my next project all lined up. Man, look at that awesome light bar. I mean, it's made for like a big fancy bathroom or something, but geez, 30 bucks, about 16 bucks for, or 18 bucks for the LED bulbs, 6 watts each, about 48 watts total. And man, does it kick out the light. I found this one, this fixture, just sitting there unused, hammered into that wall, totally disconnected. Thought I might as well dust it up and dust it off and put it back into use. Yeah, loving it. Now I'm getting ready to build that little adapter plate for this microwave. Good times. Somebody said, I'm going to take a shot every time you say good times. So that's two. I always save my manuals. And I also do a Google search for these numbers or whatever. Sometimes there's like this little document number in the back as well. And you can do like a search, an advanced search for PDFs. And I like to download the manuals and stick them in my phone. I have manuals for pretty much everything I own. And that way I can actually, if there's some feature that I need to know about, I can pull the manual up on my phone and do a quick word search through the PDF document and go straight to it. And it saves so much time. Got all the manuals for pretty much all the make and models of the trucks that I work on, and of course the engines. And they're all in my phone, and I can instantly just punch it up and have the information I need. Good times. That's three. Anyway, I was just thinking about recall about, you know, maybe 10 years ago, in the past, people would like, especially the media, they would all be like talking about, oh, so-and-so had a midlife crisis and he left his family and how terrible men are. they make no mention of the fact that women break up marriages vastly more often, insanely more often than guys do. Mainly, what I wanted to bring up about that is, you know, some of you young guys might not understand that. I mean, you may have heard about it, but you might not really understand the fact that when you are in your 40s, and especially your late 40s, your sex drive doesn't go away, but it certainly drops away. It's like the difference between like a large tiger that's starving and a rather unruly cat. For example, I mean, I probably don't even have 5% of the sex drive that I once had as a young man. That is a pretty close estimate. I mean, in the past, it used to just be there all the friggin' time and just never give me a moment of peace. But now it is different. And I mean, in the past, there were women that could just make me just become confused and distracted, and I would be dropping things, and it often got very embarrassing. But these days, it's just not there. Not the way it used to be. I mean, it can easily be ignored now. But here's an example. You know, so many years of having that big-ass sex drive, so many years of that, and then within just a few short years, it just dropped down and down and down until it's not hardly anything. it's very similar to the surprise you might feel. You know, I mean, I see a really beautiful young woman and it's like, and I like brace myself for the freaking sex drive and it doesn't happen anymore, right? Now, there are guys out there, you know, who have had, you know, like very successful love lives and they're like alphas or whatever, and they married the cheerleader and and became a lawyer or whatever, and they are used to success with women, you know. And not, I mean, I've had some success, but not, it hasn't been stellar. But the thing is, these guys, I think those are the people who have, I mean, every myth and every legend has a grain of truth in it. And I think the midlife crisis, I think that it has come from those particular men, you know, the alpha types, you know, the successful types who married the cheerleader, that sort of thing. Now, what happens to them when they reach their mid-40s to late-40s? The sex drive that they once had drops down rather dramatically, and they're addicted to it. You know, they are addicted to having that powerful sex drive because they've been able to fulfill it regularly. And when it goes away, I mean, you could imagine that they would be kind of sad about that, and they would miss it, right? So basically, what I'm thinking this midlife crisis thing is that these guys, they are, of course, they're married to women who are getting older, you know, and they probably are just, they're just trying to turn up the volume by leaving whatever sort of dumpy, frumpy woman they're with, right, and trading her in for like a 20-year-old or a 25-year-old. He goes out and buys a sports car and tries to jump down in the generations and date women who are like vastly younger than them, and it might have some effect. I mean, if you're getting hard of hearing, you know, you need people to shout in order to be heard, right? For you to hear them. And if you have like a flagging sex drive, you might need somebody who's sexier to remind you of what it was all about, you know. And you think, or he thinks, that those people will, those women will bring it all back. But I doubt seriously that it does, and I doubt it's very fulfilling, you know. For me, for you young guys, you might not understand what's heading or coming your way, but when I hit maybe 40, the sex drive just started dropping steadily, you know, until it was like 45-ish, and it's dropped even faster. And I don't know if it stabilized. I think it might have stabilized at like 5% of what it was. And the surprise that I feel when I run into like a very beautiful woman, right, who used to be able to just make me fall to pieces, right, these days, and I expect it, and it's not there, right? And it's very similar to an example. I'm sure you've been at a table or been eating a meal or halfway through a meal, and you're distracted or talking to somebody, and you reach out for your cup, right? And you think that it's full, right? So you automatically sort of reach out and and give it a little more oomph to lift it than you need, and it ends up going woo, because it's like a third as heavy as you thought it was going to be. That's what it's like. That moment of surprise, it happens very quick, and it's just not there anymore. And the awesome thing about that is, it gives you a hell of a lot more peace. And that, I'm afraid to say that if there's like a 20-year-old MGTOW, I mean, he might be as happy as I am 10 years down the MGTOW path, or he might not be, because I didn't start seeing any real decline in my sex drive till I was like in my 40s. And but before that, it was like, man, I was horny as can be, and I was lonely too, and geez. And I'm kind of concerned that maybe young guys won't find the peace that I have until they reach the age that I am. And I hope I'm wrong. And I'm wondering if that is true. I mean, are there any younger MGTOWs who have been at it for maybe 5 or 6 years who actually have found the peace that I have? Or am I just, I hope I'm not leading everybody down an incorrect path. And because for me, the peace really didn't start hitting until I was like probably late 30s. Yeah. Oh, well, there you go. I'm still working on that adapter plate for my microwave. And now I'd better start getting ready to crash, because I've got to get up real early in the morning. See ya.